New Zealand went to the polls on Saturday, October 14th. 2 days later, MPs descend on Parliament. New Zealand First's Shane Jones compares coalition talks to the cooking of a very long hangi. Winston Peters arrives in the capital but remains tight-lipped. A week later, it's revealed Christopher Luxon and his wife had dinner with Winston Peters at his home. The special votes count is revealed on November 3rd, National losing 2 seats, and Winston Peters is once again kingmaker. More than 3 weeks since the election, all 3 parties are yet to get into the same room. Winston Peters finally meets David Seymour face-to-face on November 9th. 4 days later, Christopher Luxon admits it's unlikely he'll form a government in time to make APEC and defends his negotiating skills. National and ACT leaders wait in Wellington for a meeting with Winston Peters, but he's a no-show. Christopher Luxon and David Seymour fly to Auckland for a big development, all three finally face-to-face in one room. By scooter and by foot, National's big guns arrive at Auckland's Cordis Hotel for talks. Winston Peters also visits. 3 days later, and Christopher Luxon says they're down to the final 3 difficult issues. The next day brings mixed messages. Christopher Luxon saying policy programs have been agreed with both ACT and New Zealand First. The other party's not so sure. David Seymour saying the National leader had one too many Weet-Bix. 2 days ago, David Seymour puts his hand up for the Deputy Prime Minister role and says ACT should get more cabinet seats because the party's got more MPs. And Deputy Prime Minister was one of the final issues left to deal with as MPs started heading back to Wellington. Now, 41 days on from Election Day, Christopher Luxon is Prime Minister, Winston Peters his deputy for 1.5 years, after which David Seymour takes over as number 2.